The Spanish Grand Prix has been a permanent fixture on the Formula One calendar for over 30 years now, and for good reason. Do you remember Michael Schumacher's absolute dominance here in that rain-soaked Grand Prix in 1996? That day he took his first ever victory for Ferrari, and we've had many more iconic moments since. The Circuit de Barcelona counts an efficient downforce package and bravery on the part of the driver, especially through the blind right of Turn 9, which we might just see taken flat this weekend. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have...
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. Cede that position or we'll receive a penalty. What we like to see at the start. Well done. Is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Somewhere on the island. ICE, be aware that we will start to see a loss of power. Is 3.1 seconds. We're leading our teammate by 3.7 seconds. The position, try to keep focus. We'll be right back. advise moving to mix 2, fuel to mix 2. The gap to the car ahead is 8.4 seconds. Is a second a lap faster than you. Engine is looking a little worn. Power output will be less than optimal. Stop to go. One stop left in this strategy. You have four laps till your pit window opens. Gap to car in front is 5.8 seconds. To teammate behind is 5.3 seconds. Issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Lando, you'll be on the hards. Gap ahead is 7.2 seconds. Didn't catch that. Say again. Is one of the McLarens. This lap, push hard on the in lap. Go now. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. is in the pits. Mick in the pits. Our gap to the car in front is 7.1 seconds. Just fitted the hard tyres, car behind, running hards. To the car ahead is 7.1 seconds. Dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. has come in to fit the mediums. Car ahead, now running medium tyres. Slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. We're leading our teammate by 7.1 seconds. They're on old hards. They're in 13th. The time last lap was a 1 minute 20.8. Say that again, we're having trouble receiving. Managing your tyres. Manage your tyres. Gap to car in front is 6.0 seconds. want some information on Hamilton, they're retiring from the race. Caution, caution. The virtual safety car is out. Reduce speed and maintain a positive delta. Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. VSC ending. We're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Yellow flag. To teammate behind is 9.6 seconds. Okay, clear. Expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. Gap ahead is 18.2 seconds. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Burned off our excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. lost some time to the car behind. There's a significant amount of wear on the engine now. Our gap to the car in front is 22.2 seconds. Of fuel remaining. The car ahead is 26.2 seconds. Is leading the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. The end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
They've done it then. A spectacular victory here in Spain and a massive confidence boost going into the next race. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
And I can see the drivers' three celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. Let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. More points for Valtteri Bottas, further solidifying his lead at the top of the table. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
It's got to be Lando Norris, hasn't it? Smooth, confident and assured. I've got no doubt that he and his team are going to be over the moon with his performance today.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for